If you're a data scientist, you probably use R daily. But did you know you can also use this programming language for web scraping? Today, I'll show you how to extract static pages, HTML tables, and dynamic content with R and RStudio. Let's get started. First, let's start with static pages. For this, you'll need R and RStudio installed. Once ready, launch the app and open a new RScript file. The package needed for scraping is rvest. You can get it by typing the install packages command in the console below. When installed, import rvest to your script. Start by creating a URL object followed by the website you want to scrape. We'll target a website made to practice web scraping. Then, we'll read the HTML of the page and assign it to a web page object. In the following line, select the HTML nodes we want to scrape. To determine the correct node, right-click on the website, click Inspect, and look through the HTML structure. Find the class name or IDs that match the content you need. For our example, the elements we want have a class called Country. The dot before Country indicated that it's a class attribute. An ID attribute would instead have a hashtag. A quick tip, if you click the small icon in the top left corner and hover over elements in the browser developer tools, it will highlight them so you can double check you've got the right one. Now, you can scrape each element one by one. Like in this example, a specific node is extracted and the output is cleaned with the HTML text function. However, we are not just interested in getting the country names. We also want other data, such as population. So, the most efficient way is to create an empty data frame and, with a for loop, iterate through multiple HTML nodes. Let's create a data frame first. We add columns for country names, capitals, populations, and areas. Next, we start a for loop and list all the data points we want to extract. Here, for each country interaction, HTML node selects different class elements and HTML text cleans the output. For numeric values like population or area, we assign as numeric parameters. Finally, finish the for loop by binding our extracted data to the empty data frame. It ensures our data is formatted into a neat table. We can check if everything works by printing the results to our console. To save the results in a CSV format, use the write.csv function. And that's it. Now, let's see how to scrape HTML tables. For this, you'll need the same rvest package. Import it at the beginning of your script. Like for the static pages, start by defining the URL object. As an example, I chose a Wikipedia table with the Eurovision Song Contest winners. Next, we read the HTML content of the web page. The final step would be telling which HTML node the CSS selector should target. Then, we use the HTML table function to parse the table into the variable. Now, you can print the table to your console or save it as a CSV file. One more thing we can do with the rvest package is to scrape JavaScript rendered pages. Start by loading rvest and tidyverse packages. Next, we define the website we are targeting. In this case, is the quote to scrape site, another sandbox for practicing web scraping. Define a scrape package function to extract quotes, authors, and tags from a single page. Start by reading the HTML content of the provided URL. Then, we select and extract the quotes using CSS selectors. Like before, we find the required HTML nodes by inspecting the page via developer's tools. The same process is repeated for quote authors. Finally, we repeat the process for quotes. However, since each quote has multiple tags, we use the gsub function to remove the prefix tags and separate each data point with commas. As a result, we'll get all tags from the same quote in one table row. Next, create an empty data frame, all quotes, to store the scraped data. Finally, end the function by returning the data frame as the result. Since many JavaScript pages can have pagination, let's add code to go through multiple pages and extract the data from each. With the next page object, we initialize the pagination process by starting the first page. Page count sets a counter to keep the track of the page number. Initialize the data frame with the following code lines. Then, this function loops through pages as long as there's a next page and the page count is 10. You can scrape more or fewer pages by adjusting the number. Next, combine the base URL with a relative path for the next page. It's optional, but we also add the message function to tell us which page is being scraped in the console. The following lines call the previously established scrape page function to extract data from the current page. Then, append the newly scraped data to the main data frame. Last, we find the next page link by targeting the HTML node associated with the next button and incrementing the page counter. Let's print the results. Like before, we save everything to a CSV file. If scraping other websites, you can customize the file name or save additional columns. That's all you need to scrape static pages, HTML content, and dynamic content with R. If you want to learn more, I've left some useful resources in the video description. To improve your web scraping skills, check out our other web scraping tutorials, and I'll see you in another video.